Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this session, we will get acquainted with Flex and learn how we can have a responsive appearance. In the previous session, we got acquainted with styling and we did it in line with the help of a style sheet. Now suppose we want to design the appearance of the page in such a way that it's responsive on different devices and doesn't get cluttered. To do this, we can use Flex, and in fact, without using the exact dimensions, we use the ratio of width and height of the page. Well, I remove the extra code and create three more views in the main view with separate styles to explain the Flex on them. For now, I define dimensions as fixed, such as a 100 pixel square. As we saw in the previous session, by adding the align items and justify content as a center, we can show the content of the view in the center. Well, I copy the created view and change their numbers. I also separate the styles and give them different colors to distinguish them. Well, as we did in the previous sessions, by setting the Flex to 1 in the main view, we expanded its size to the entire page. I changed its color to distinguish it from the background. In a view, if we don't use Flex or fixed sizes, its dimensions become large enough to accommodate the content inside. Here I set the width and height of the main view to a fixed number. As you can see, the content orientation is columnar by default. Using Flex direction, we can change this direction. Column applied by default. And the difference with the column reverse is that the column reverse puts the content from the bottom to top, but the column from the top to bottom does this. The row also sorts the content from left to right, and the row reverse from right to left. Well, again, I give view a Flex value of 1. Now we test the Flex on the content inside the main view. For example, if we give view number 1 a Flex with a value of 1, it will mean that the share of the other two views will be their fixed sizes, and the share of view number 1 will be the rest of the remaining space. Of course, this only happens at the height of the views, and their width is as much as the text inside them. The reason for which we will examine a little later. Now, if I give the other two views a Flex value of 1, all three views use the same amount of a screen. If I set the value of Flex of the first view equal to 2, as we can see, the size of the first view will be twice the size of the other two views. And if I make it 3, it becomes 3 times as much. Now, if the other two views have the value of Flex 3, the ratio will still be equal and their size will be equal. So, as you can see, the amount of Flex indicates the ratio between the other contents. And if there is no other content, Flex will cover the entire screen. So, if I use Flex 1 for all three views instead of Flex 3, their ratio will not change. Well, now let's take a look at align items and justify content, which we've seen so far. If we change the value of align items, we see that it affects the content horizontally, and this happens when the flex direction is the column. Flex start does the content layout from the left, and flex end does it from the right. Also, if we select the value of the stretch, it expands the content. If the flex direction is column and we change the justify content, it affects vertically. But here we don't see this change because the content covers the whole page. Now we change the flex direction to row, and as you can see, this time the align items was affected vertically. Flex start from top, flex end from the bottom, and the center puts the content in the center of the main view. Now I set the size of the views to see the justify content change. If flex direction is equal to row, justify content will affect horizontally. So flex start from the left and flex end from the right puts the content. The space between creates a space between the contents. Space around and space evenly create a distance around each view. Also, if flex direction is column, it will affect the justify content vertically. The effect of flex start when the flex direction is column or row is top and left. And when it's reverse, it's bottom and right. Well, now I return the views to cover the entire screen. Here is a summary of what we learned. Now create a page similar to this page for practice. Of course, the source code related to this exercise is placed in the GitHub of this tutorial series. The link is in the description. So there we go, we got acquainted with Flex and its usage in responsive page design. Now if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to share, subscribe and like. And I'll see you in the next session.